Three deaths at the Justice Center in Clayton so far this year are now getting some extra attention.
A committee will now take a closer look at how daily procedures are conducted at the jail to see if there is a problem. Fox 2's Jeff Bernthal is live with what the committee will be looking for. Jeff?
St. Louis County Councilmember Ernie Trakas says that committee will meet April 16th to take a look at the policies here, how they're carried out, including how medical attention is given to detainees.
I feel like I'm gonna get justice for him.
Tashonda Troop is on a mission to find out why her son Lamar Catchings died in the St. Louis County Justice Center March 1st.
I don't know how he died, why he died, why he didn't get any medical care.
She holds weekly meetings researching jail conditions and recently pleaded with the St. Louis County Council for help.
I don't want this to happen to anyone else. I don't want another mother to feel like I feel right now.
Maybe we can get some answers.
Angie Zorich was a longtime friend with inmate John Shy, who died in custody. A source telling our partners at the Post-Dispatch an internal investigation looked into whether the inmate's call button in the infirmary was intentionally deactivated.
You never know when you're going to find yourself in a situation, and you might end up spending the night in jail. I mean, you want to hope that you come out alive, if it's your son, if it's your brother.
It's alarming.
St. Louis County Councilwoman Lisa Clancy hopes a scheduled committee hearing will produce answers while the internal investigation continues.
First, we need to start broad and just get our arms around what the basic policies and procedures are to make sure that the well-being of inmates is attended to. And it might be such that policies, when we get into the investigations, that policies were followed. But are those policies the best practices? There's a lot we need to find out.
A number of us were not comfortable waiting anymore. And so we're going to begin a general overview of practices at the Justice Center as it relates to the care of detainees.
Councilman Ernie Trakas says it's what families of inmates deserve.
Now, they need to know that their loved ones, relatives, whatever, are not in danger.
Now, the acting director here at the Justice Center has told council members that she can't go into details about these investigations until those investigations are complete. And again, council members say it's quite possible that everything here has been by the book. Reporting live from Clayton, Jeff Bernthal, Fox 2 News.